So as I said, this video is going to be a little bit of an extension. If you want to learn how to return multiple values, I'm going to show you how on earth we actually do that here. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to copy that line there because we're going to add this extra function in right here. And what it's going to do is it's going to get the base and height from the user, and it will return the base and height back to the calling program. So this is going to be definition get, and it's going to get multiple values. And what's going to happen is it's going to start by getting the values from the user. So instead of having these lines of code here, they're going to run in this function. Hold on. They're going to run in this function right here. So we're getting the values of base and height from the user. Then if we want to return two values, we can simply write return base, comma, height. This will return both the base and the height back to the calling program. And when we call this, the only thing that's a little bit different is that when we save the values, we need to create our own base and height to save them in up here. So this is kind of like that splitting lesson, that splicing lesson I talked about, where we could actually slice up something and save it in multiple different, slice up a string and save it in multiple different variables. This is the same general idea. Here we're going to return two values. And as a result, when we call this function, we need to have two values in order for those two returned values to save inside of. So then we run this and test it out. You'll see it prompts me. I'm going to enter in 6, 10, and it's still able to calculate. So kind of a cool little addition. If you want to write a program that returns multiple values, this is really what you would do. So here you can return two values. And here we're getting two values from the user, saving them both in two separate variables. There you go. That's a little trick for if you want to know how to return two values back to your main calling program.